squad, who will be met by the detachment senior instructor, Captain Mackenzie, LAM. After he is received on parade, he will be invited to inspect the parade. Following the inspection, the course will march past in slow and quick time, after which they will advance in review order. This done, the reviewing officer will then present student awards.
in slow and quick time. One platoon leading. Course by the limit. Slow.
Thank you. Today, the reviewing officer presents two awards, the first being the most improved student. This award is for the student who has doggedly worked his way through the course and has continuously shown improvement. The most improved student for the 3 of 89 course is Corporal R.J. Sands from 122 Signal Street. The next presentation is the imposing Ray Simpson VC Award. Correction, Ray Simpson VC Student of Merit Prize. This is awarded to the student who most clearly displays the qualities and knowledge expected in a sergeant. Ladies and gentlemen, the student of merit for the 3 of 89 Subject 1 Sergeant course is Corporal K.L. Butner, Royal Australian Signal Corps. Corporal Butner enlisted in the Army in January 1981 and is currently posted to 152 Signal Squadron. Headquarters Training Command on the 6th of February 1980, to Army Office on the 24th of February 1982, and to 1st Training Group on the 28th of November 1984. Corporal Hegan joined the Land Warfare Centre Victorian Detachment on the 8th of April 1987 and is employed as the admin clerk.
Senior instructor and staff of the Land Warfare Centre Victoria Detachment, members of the 3 of 89 Subject 1 Sergeant Course, and ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to be here today in the Victorian Sun reviewing this parade. And can I say first of all that I thought it was a good parade, that your drill was good, and your turnout was good. So my congratulations on that effort. I also say on your behalf, thank you to the band from the School of Music for coming and supporting this parade. Again, without their support, the parade loses something of its significance, and we at the Land Warfare Centre are grateful for that support and acknowledge it publicly today. I've only got a couple of short points that I'd like to make today. And the first of those is that some of you may come from parts of the Army that are beset by many day-to-day problems, or challenges if you prefer. And sometimes when we're in that situation, we almost tend to forget that we've got a good Army. It's not all problems, it's not all shortages, it's not all resource constraints. In fact, Australia has a fine army, a small one, but relevant to anyone else you'd like to name, a very good army. And that's something that none of us should forget in the hassle of our day-to-day existence. We're part of a very good army with fine traditions, and I'm sure we all intend to keep it that way. I am convinced that at the present time, our army is fitter, better trained, and more capable than it has been in the past 25 years, about which I can speak from my experience. So it's important that we don't forget that. I think the strength of our army has always been in its individuals. With individual soldiers, non-commissioned officers, senior non-commissioned officers, warrants and officers. And you, of course, are a very important part of that army. You are all important individuals. Without you, the army cannot function, and without you developing and taking your part higher up those levels, the army will not have a future. In recognition of the importance of you all as individuals, the army has devoted quite a lot of resources to the conduct of this course. And you should, of course, also bear in mind that concurrent with your course here at Watsonia, a similar course is just concluding at Singleton and at Inogra. And again concurrently, we have 90 sergeants and staff sergeants undergoing the Subject 1 for Warrant Officer course at Canungra. So that's a lot of individual students, and it means a lot of resources devoted to those particular courses by our nation. And you only have to think your travel here, your accommodation, the time that you're away from your job, the resources of the senior instructor and the staff, and all the material that has been put into your time here. It doesn't come cheap. Now all those resources at this stage have been spent. We can't get them back, and the acid question is, has it been worth it? And really, only you as individuals can answer that question. Have you in fact put in your maximum effort and gained the most from this training? You came here with different backgrounds, different experience and expertise, and no one expected everyone to perform equally well. It's also very self-evident that not everyone passed the course. Personally, I don't think that is really the question. The question is, have you gained from the course? Have you learned something about the skills and knowledge required of you? Have you improved, and have you put in your maximum effort? If the answer to all those questions is yes, the expenditure of those resources has been well worth it, regardless of whether you pass or fail the course. Of course, the challenge of the course is only one little aspect of the challenge of your continuing career in the Army. When you go back to your units, the challenge is still going to be there. And I suggest that the challenge will still be, are you putting in the maximum effort for those below you and for those above you, for your Army and our country? But if you can look yourself in the mirror and say, yes, I am, you deserve the stripes you're wearing, and in due course those which you may be awarded. Some of you will have noticed, as you've had your time here at the attachment, that flying around the place is the LWC flag. It's also displayed in your mess and in your lecture room. On it, you will have seen the tiger, the many-headed dragon symbol. Some of you will know that the Hydra is a figure from great Greek mythology. It was one of the labours of Hercules to kill the Hydra, and his problem was that every time he cut off a head, two more grew in its place. It was only with the help of his friend and with a great deal of perseverance and ingenuity that he was able to overcome the Hydra. The significance of it to Land Warfare Centre, and particularly to you as students on this course and to your future careers, is that whenever you solve a problem in your day-to-day job, there are bound to be others appear. The job is never finished. It is only with the help of your superiors and subordinates that you will overcome those problems, and only with the knowledge and ingenuity and perseverance for which the Australian soldier is famous. And we hope that in a small way this course has contributed to banding you together as a group of junior NCOs in our army and providing you with more friends to help with the solving of these problems, and that you have also gained the knowledge and the desire to persevere and to overcome the problems that present themselves in your day-to-day job. If we've achieved that, again, we've been successful, and so have you. You might recall last evening that I read to you the words of the warrant presented to Warrant Officer Snow, and I might remind you of part of that now. And so to conduct yourself that you ensure respect for lawful authority and uphold the honourable tradition of the rank to which you have been appointed. I think if you think about those words, they give a worthy aim not only for warrant officers but for all ranks in our army, and I commend them to you. In conclusion, again, congratulations on the parade. Congratulations to those who have passed the course. And I remind all of you of the challenge that lies before you back in your unit. I hope that you will have a safe trip if you are travelling to far places on your return, and that you will attack your jobs with renewed vigour as a result of the course. So good luck and good soldiering.